In this video, we'll be talking about conditions, when to use them in your test steps, and the benefits. Before we continue, we will assume that you've already created a login to Testim and have created some tests. So let's get started. Conditions in Testim can control how a test step or a shared step is executed. So you might ask, why would I want to use conditions? So let's say, for example, that you only want to run a login shared step when the text login appears on the page, or maybe you only want to click the login button when that object is actually visible. Okay. So if we click on a test step here, we see that, and we click on this gear icon, we scroll down and we click on when to run step. We can see that there are five options for when to run a step. Always run. This is actually going to be the default setting for all test steps unless it's changed. There's element, element text, custom, and never. So if we go ahead and click on this next test step here, we can see that we have it set to look for an element text. So if we reassign here, just to show you what it looks like, we're clicking on the login text on the screen. So essentially what this shared step is going to do, as we can see, this is a login step. This shared step, what this step is going to do is essentially, if the login text login appears on the screen, then we're going to execute this shared step. If it doesn't appear, it's not going to work. So if we actually go ahead and run this, we can see that this shared step is going to run because it's looking for if the text login appears on the page, and we can see that that step existed. But if we wanted to actually pause and actually change it, see what it looks like when it would fail, we change it to this and then we try to run it, we're going to see that this step's actually going to fail. It's not actually going to log into the product, which is an expected behavior. And we can see here, we click on this and we can see we get more specific information about that. Okay. All right. So the next one that I wanted to talk about, let's go back and change this back. We'll change this to log in. Okay. The next one I wanted to touch on was this concept of doing an element. So here we're looking for the option where the element. So in this example for logout, it's only going to run if this element logout is visible. Okay. If it's not visible, it's not going to run. So another basic example there. And finally, if we wanted to touch on this concept of skip, we can see that if we change this step to skip, this step is actually not going to run. So what this step does is it just prints something out to the console. If we go ahead and run this particular step, we can see that it's actually going to skip and it's never going to run step two in the test case here. We can see that because we see this icon here. Okay. And finally, the last thing to touch on is this concept of setting a specific condition. So this shared step, we're going to loop and we're going to run through this shared step several times. But the other option we have here is if we wanted to go in, we could actually write custom JavaScript. So it's actually going to check for a particular condition. And if that condition is met or not, it's going to determine whether it's going to continue to run the step or not. So this is an example of actually passing in some custom JavaScript to do that. So hopefully this provided a nice overview of conditions in Testim, when you would use them, how they could be helpful in your testing. Go out to the website or feel free to reach out to us if you have additional questions.